Hi everybody, one of the most common questions I get asked is how the rear surround bonds into the cut Jetta, Charger, Audi, or Subi. And this is the rear surround, and all of the Smyth kits are pretty much the same, with the exception of the Charger. The Charger has a three-piece rear surround, and the rest of the cars have a one-piece like this one. So the trick is, and this is one of the messier jobs in the kit, so if you can do this, you can pretty much do everything else with ease. The piece comes rough trimmed, but this edge, come on in and take a zoom here, this edge right here, you see where I described a line, you know, as it's rough trimmed, this whole little edge here is about 3/8 of an inch. A half an inch would be too much, I think. You know, a quarter is too little. I do about, and you can zoom down here, this is about 3/8 of an inch thick. So from the top edge here to this edge here, I just take a razor blade and I scribe a line. And I hate to say it, but the fastest way to make sure that the rear window fits is to take a 36 grit disc on a little grinder and literally just kiss the fiberglass with the grinder to make sure that you have a consistent flange depth all the way around the part. So that's thing one. Get your rear surround, and I'll flip it upside down so you can see the raw fiberglass inside that we're going to bond the window to. So come on in here, take a look. This is the raw, ugly inside of the fiberglass that you would probably be painting with a bed liner or covering with black carpet in the final car. That's up to you. You can see here, I'll try to move this so you can see it. Here's our 3/8 of an inch flange, and you can see how it's sticking up here. We're gonna be taking this window, and we're gonna be placing the window into this opening from the inside of the car. So I have the rear surround flat on a table. I have my seam ground down to about 3/8 of an inch. And we're gonna be placing this window, smooth side out, into the opening. And this is the question I get. So, and this drops into the opening, that's fine. You can use windshield adhesive around the surface. So I like to put about a half an inch of bead of windshield adhesive right in here, along the edge, so that it sticks up a little. I put a little bit of windshield adhesive with my finger, with gloves on, of course. Put my little bit of windshield adhesive along here, not so much that it oozes out when you put it in place. And then you set the window into the opening. And the windshield adhesive bonds to the frame after sanding it. We have this in the manual and in another video. But what I want to talk about today is the biggest reason people have leaks in their cars, and we're talking about Audis, Subarus, and Jettas. The biggest reason they have leaks is the bottom edge of the sliding window, and this is the window that comes with your car. The bottom edge has these little drains on them. So take a look here. Right in here, you see little rectangular drains. There's one all the way up against the bonding surface right here, and there's another one all the way out to the edge of this underside. You can see I actually take a piece of tape and I cover just, and remember this is the outside of the window right here, I cover the drain hole with two pieces of tape at each hole. Now you probably don't need all 8 or 10 of these drains. You can see I've taped them all off, but if you put tape on them, you can be rest assured that when you bond your window into the opening and you set it into the opening, and you put your black windshield adhesive around the outside, checking how flush the window is to the outside. You basically, you know, pick it up while it's being bonded and take a look and see if you like the gap that you see here. Remember, the gap can be adjusted by putting little blocks under the adhesive around the edges. So once you like the way it's sitting, double check it from the other side. When that thing starts to cure, and it's cured hard enough where the window won't fall out if you flip it over, go to the other side and pull your blue tape, pull this tape off after the adhesive is bound, and pull your little piece of tape out. And when the tape comes out, that will make sure that there is enough, and just, you know, that's why I use the blue removable tape. There should be enough where water that happens to get down inside here can drain out to the outside of the car. And that's it. That's the biggest trick, biggest question. Probably the hardest thing to do on the Smyth kit is what I just described here, and then that whole assembly then can be fit onto the car after it's been cut. No leaks if you keep the drains open on the bottom edge of the window. And then the last bit of adhesive, you can put windows in place, right? You can just take it on your finger, squeegee it around the outside under that edge, and permanently bond the window into position. That's all.